Welcome everyone to WWA Action! In quite a predicament lately, as Cheese encountered the wrath of the new number one contender at the WWA Women's Championship, whom she will be facing on Sunday, October 14th, at WWA's upcoming high risk event. It was in the last episode of WWA Action, Martinez backstage preparing for a match when she was attacked and powerbombed against the locker room. Martinez still suffering injuries from that. And here's the kicker. Tonight, Grace Perkins has a big, big opportunity to go one-on-one against the WWA Women's Champion. If she walks out with a victory tonight, she could make a case for why she should be the number one contender at the WWA Women's Championship. All thanks to the injuries that were sustained last week in the backstage brawl. Of course, the number one contender at the Women's Championship, Emily Wells, has to be watching this match very closely. We know she inflicted those injuries on Michelle Martinez on the last episode of WWA Action, and the whole point of inflicting these injuries is perhaps to slow down Martinez, as Martinez is scheduled to face Emily for the championship Sunday, October 14th, at high risk. Oh, wow. And Perkins looking mighty vicious in the opening goings of this match. And a reversal here by the champion. Kick to the back of the leg. The champion now sending Perkins to the ropes. And a huge boot to the face. Off the boot, shoulders down, hoops the leg, and a kick out by Perkins. You know, I think Michelle Martinez has been doing great as WWA Women's Champion since she won that championship back in August. From the longest reigning champion in WWA history, Ashley. But I think all of us, Michelle included, perhaps underestimated the power of the new number one contender, Emily Wells. Emily Wells has been a huge surprise here in the WWA Women's Division. And she seemed harmless at the beginning, but after becoming number one contender just a few weeks ago, Emily Wells has shown her true colors, and now Wells is hell-bent on taking that championship from Martinez. Nice reversal here by Martinez, shoulders down, is it enough to put Perkins away? Could it be? Perkins turns it around! Martinez turns it around, shoulders down! Perkins turns it around! And a kick out by the champion! This shows you the power of both of these women here in the World Wrestling Association. Martinez carries her, sends her back down to the canvas. Martinez sending Perkins against the corner. Perkins in trouble. Shoulder first into the turnbuckle post. And now going for the knee to the face. Perkins moves out of the way. Backbreaker by Perkins. And you could perhaps make the question that maybe Martinez is off her game. She reverses here with a nice Huracanrana. Martinez going to the top rope. Martinez with a beautiful moonsault up the top rope. Shoulders down, hooks the leg. Is it enough? The move break is away. Yes, it is. Michel Martinez with a victory here tonight. Oh boy, and speaking of which, here's Emily Wells. Emily Wells is in the ring with the champion. And this is another unwanted attack. Oh man, much like the one we saw last week when Wells attacked Martinez and powerbombed her on the locker room. And now Wells sending Martinez to the corner. Slice bread number two by Wells. Emily with a belly-to-belly suplex. And Emily Wells is looking to put her away right here. Pump handle. Toss back. Emily Wells just sent a huge message to the champion. And we are back live on WWA Action. The five-time WWA Tag Team Champions, Pure Power, are looking to position themselves back on top of the WWA Tag Team Division, which is becoming a very crowded field as of late. But tonight, Pure Power gets to go one-on-one against the Brotherhood to reignite an old rivalry. Brotherhood making their return here tonight at WWA Action. They are also decorated tag team champions here in the WWA, have held those tag titles on five different occasions, just the same as Pure Power. And through all the highs and their lows, the Brotherhood have managed to survive every tag team that has come through the World Wrestling Association. This is a team that also wants to put themselves back in a good position in the WWA Tag Team Division. There's the bell, here we go. Corner on elbow tie up. That's Andrew in the ring with Austin Parker. And the referee needs to break this up, and look at Andrew, come on! And that pisses off Mike Pure. Andrew looking to capitalize here, but it's Austin Parker, the one that gets the advantage. Reversal by Andrew. I was about to say Andrew and arm drag in the same sentence, and folks, it is not easy. Two ropes, him in the middle. Oh, forearm shot by Austin Parker to the face of Andrew Kendall. Suplex. By Austin Parker takes down Andrew. Andrew reverses the kick to the head of Parker. Standing drop kick there by Andrew Kendall. And now in the ropes, Austin Parker in trouble, sent back to the ropes. In the middle again, but this time Parker reverses with a jawbreaker. Parker now hooks him in. Reversal again by Andrew Kendall. Back and forth we go. Nice European uppercut there. We're talking about repositioning yourself. We have a new tag team on the block in the team of The Watch. These two are long-standing tag teams here in the World Wrestling Association. Two here waiting to see what the next defense of the Tag Team Championship will be. Spinning dropkick there by Austin Parker. Parker hooks him in, belly to belly suplex. Now it's Andrew the one that's in trouble. Dropping knee on the head of Andrew. Going to the second rope here. And waiting for Andrew to get back to his feet. Parker now off the second rope, but Andrew swats him out of the air. Reversal by Parker though, puts him back in position. And forth we go, this time Fear Power takes control again. Reversal by Andrew. Andrew now sending Austin Parker to the other side of the ring. Wrong zip code there for Parker. Tag is made. Here comes Anthony. To the ropes. Double elbows to the face and a huge tag team maneuver there by the Brotherhood. And now it's Anthony Kendall in the ring with Austin Parker. Parker sent to the corner again. Kendall bad intentions. Knee to the plexus. Parker's trying to tag out and he does. Tag is made. Here comes Mike Pure. And Pure gets caught off right at the beginning with a huge crossline. Pure had this idea of coming in and cleaning the house and that did not happen. Top rope, but this time Pure moves out of the way. Kick to the back. Tries to go for it again. This time Anthony moves out of the way. Anthony tries to hook him in here. Slams him back down to the canvas, and that's gotta hurt, folks. And now it's Mike Fury in a precarious position. To the corner, run zip code, tag is made. Here comes Andrew. Are we gonna see it again? Double arm drag this time by the Brotherhood. Beautifully done. The Brotherhood is looking to finish this one off right here. Kendall hooks him in for the Kendall twist. Austin Parker dropped off the corner, shoulders down, hoops the leg, is it enough to put him away? Could it be? And a kick out of two by Mike Pure, the pure resiliency of Michael. Reversal here by Pure. Pure now tries to hook him in for a powerbomb. Is he gonna get it? But no, reversal DDT. Pure, he's able to withstand huge amounts of punishment. Question is for how long? Tag is made. There we see it once again. Oh no, tag is made! Will that open the window for Austin Parker? But Mike Pure is hurt. He's on the outside of the ring. Reversal here by Anthony Kendall. Anthony now sent to the corner. Austin Parker, bad intentions. Parker has to do this one on his own. DDT! And Parker's looking to finish it off right here, but a reversal by Anthony, neckbreaker! Off the neckbreaker! But the reversal! Back and forth we go, Anthony's back in control, Steven Turner still nowhere to be found! Kendall twist connects on Austin Parker. Steven Turner still knocked out on the side of the ring. Shoulders down, hooks the leg. Is it enough to put him away? Yes, it is. The Brotherhood take the victory. A pivotal moment in this match as the Brotherhood picks up the victory here tonight. Mostly in parts because they isolated Mike Pure. Take a look at this one more time. This double team maneuver here. Boom! Is what drove Pure to tag out. He was knocked out on the outside of the ring. He was unresponsive. It allowed the Kendalls to hit the Kendall twist and get the victory here tonight on Action. And ladies and... What the hell is... What in the world is happening? Oh my... What? No, come... No! No, stop it! Stop it, you two! Stop! No! Oh, no, 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 no! This is not good! Oh, no! Oh no, this is an implosion! This friendship of 5 years! 5-time WWA Tag Team Champions! They have been a team for over 5 years here in the World Wrestling Association! This is ludicrous! Why is Austin Parker throwing this away? Austin Parker is throwing this away! Damn it to hell! Austin Parker armed with a steel chair like a damn maniac! Mike Buhr has no other option but to fight back! And he does with a big boot, and now what seemed like an unbreakable bond, an unbreakable friendship, it no longer exists, ladies and gentlemen. It just imploded right in front of our eyes. And I can't believe what my eyes are seeing. This is one of the longest tenure tag teams here in the World Wrestling Association. And look at this. They are just hitting each other with everything. 5 tag team titles. I'm at a loss for words. The tag team here in the World Wrestling Association for so long, and now once again, Austin Parker armed with a steel chair. This man is a maniac. He's a maniac. Why would he do this? What kind of frustration will lead you to do this? And Parker looking for his signature maneuver here. Looking to plant down his best friend to the canvas. That's your best friend, you bastard. He's a freed man. Unbelievable. We are back on WWA Action. This happened moments ago. Buhr Power losing a tag team match, mostly in part to Mike Buhr not being in the corner. And this led Austin Parker to lose all of his sense. Austin Parker just went to town on his best friend and attacked him, left him laying down. Ladies and gentlemen, we're trying to get an interview with Austin Parker, trying to get an update on Mike Buhr. We'll keep you updated here on WWA Action. Stay tuned. Underway coming up on WWA Action, Jim Duncan teaming up with the light heavyweight champion Shawn Coleman to go one-on-one against the national champion John Rich and number one contender of the light heavyweight championship Kevin Devious. Still a little bit shaken here on WWA Action after the implosion of Buhr Power just a couple of minutes ago. But we move on to another tag team match. Jim Duncan gearing himself up to face John Rich in a last man standing match for the national championship Sunday, October 14th at High Risk. Well, for the light heavyweight champion tonight, it's very simple. It's much the same strategy that he has to apply come Sunday, October 14th. That is to survive. Because he has a burden weighing on his shoulders, and that is that Shawn Coleman already lost a match to Kevin Devious, and it was part of the Gold Rush tournament. That's how we ended up here. Can Shawn Coleman keep that championship Sunday, October 14th, when he defends it against Devious one more time? There you see the team of Duncan and Coleman getting ready for their opponents. I am the anti-venom! This is John Rich making his slow walk to the ring like a man who knows he's in control. From high risk, he will have the power in his hands to do what he's wanted to do for a long time, and that is to end Jim Duncan's career. John Rich, as a ranged individual, as a cutting individual, who in my mind should not be allowed to compete here in the World Wrestling Association. Somehow he is. Somehow he's a national champion. I'll tell you how. He's been focused on concussing Jim Duncan, on mushing his brain, on ending his career. We saw it at Gold Rush when he planted Duncan's face against the concrete in the arena. We've seen it here in WWA Action. And now, the tools are all there. A last man standing match could be the end of Jim Duncan's career Sunday, October 14th. Either Jim Duncan walks out with that championship or he doesn't walk out at all. Kevin Devious, because cussing attack will only get you so far in your life, but for Kevin Devious, he's gotten right where he should be. Kevin Devious was part of the Gold Rush Tournament. In the middle of the Gold Rush Tournament, he managed to score a victory against the light heavyweight champion in a one-on-one match. A victory that got him close to the finals, but he didn't win. However, coming off the Gold Rush Tournament, Kevin Devious played his card right. He said, I defeated the light heavyweight champion in a one-on-one match. I deserve a shot at that title. And now come high risk, Sunday, October 14th. It's time to put up or shut up. Meanwhile, tonight it's all about tag team action. Duncan and Coleman going one-on-one against Rich and Devious. There's the bell. Here we go. And look at Duncan not wasting any time, going after John Rich. Ladies and gentlemen, the bad blood between these two as Rich deposits Duncan over the third rope down ringside. The bad blood between these two is outstanding. They just clearly do not like each other. Devious now sent against the table. Reversal here on Duncan. He's still fighting right here in front of the broadcast position. Oh, it's the glory by Duncan right here in front of us. Beautifully done there. But Duncan once again sent against our table. Not good. Neck breaker on the outside. And this is just a little preview of what we're going to be seeing come Sunday, October 14th at high risk. Against the barricade goes Duncan. Shawn Rich just hammering away on the head of Jim. Count up to six, match returns to the ring. Jim hooks him in for a body slam. Beautifully done there by Jim, but Jim staying on top of John Rich to step up and see glory, but Rich manages to use that momentum to tag out to Devious. Devious now heads to the ring, tries to clean house. Duncan reverses, forearm to the face of Devious. And Devious is in trouble now. Tag is made. Here comes Shawn Coleman. Coleman now taking care of Devious inside the ring. Devious central ropes. Meanwhile, Duncan, he's fighting John Rich on the outside of the ring. Let me tell you, once again, the bad blood between these two is astronomical as Shawn Coleman hits a beautiful high flying maneuver on Kevin Devious. Devious hooks him in. German suplex. Meanwhile, Duncan right here in front of us takes down John Rich again. Is this the right time to get cocky, Mr. Coleman? Duncan sending John Rich face first into the steel barricade as this match escalates on the outside of the ring. Meanwhile, inside the ring, reversal by Devious. Devious now sending Coleman to the ropes. Coleman in the ropes, same in the middle. Devious hooks him in, plants him down to the canvas. On the outside of the ring, John Rich has Jim Duncan. Duncan with the reversal on John Rich. Oh, he sends him against the barricade. Devious now controlling the head of Coleman. He's looking for that springboard senton and he gets it. Now Devious working the leg of Shawn Coleman on the outside of the ring. A neck breaker to Jim Duncan. Wait for a little bit of suplex there. Devious now hooking Coleman in. Coleman reverses with a knee to the head. Oh, standing drop kick there. And Coleman signaling for it here. He's looking for those signature suplexes. That's three suplexes if you're counting at home. Cover here, shoulders down, hooks a leg. Is it enough to put him away in a kick out? And Devious in trouble here as he gets sent over the third rope down to ringside. Coleman, bad intentions, he takes up to the ropes. Tope Suicida, oh no! John Rich! Hot damn, John Rich! Cutting off Shawn Coleman after that Tope Suicida! John Rich! Bloody incredible! And Jim Duncan has made his way to the corner now with a bulldog! Duncan takes down Rich with a bulldog, but the damage could be done already. Kick to the shin. Meanwhile, in the ring, the top rope sent on by Kevin Devious. Shoulders down here on Shawn Coleman. He's hitting off the blue way. The kick out by Coleman. Jim Duncan putting on a hurting on John Rich after cutting off Shawn Coleman from his Tope Suicida with a clothesline. Devious carrying Coleman up on his shoulders, sends him drop first into those ropes. Single leg Boston Crab! Single leg Boston Crab, is it enough? Is Coleman gonna tap out here? What a reversal by Coleman! So much action going on. Shoulders down, hooks the leg. Is it enough? Put him away here. Could it be? And a kick out of the by Devious. Meanwhile, Duncan is on the winner table. And Kevin Devious now getting some shots from Duncan as well. Duncan is fire up. Dropping down a senton on Devious. Coleman with a senton of his own. And here's Duncan suplexing Rich into Kevin Devious. Goodness me. What a performance we're seeing here tonight. Tag is made. Here comes Duncan. Dropping down the elbows on Kevin Devious. Thank you. Here's Jim headed to the top rope. Moonsault off the top, shoulders down, hooks the leg, is it enough? Put him away here, could it be? And a kick out of two. You could tell the fury burning up inside Jim Duncan as he takes to the top rope here. Wait a minute, who's his target? Oh no, Duncan's target was John Rich on the outside of the ring. And Duncan looking for a powerbomb here, but Rich with the reversal. You could tell that Duncan at this stage, he's just blinded, isn't he? Blinded on hurting John Rich, and that could cost him this match here tonight. Devious looking to take advantage of the assist by John Rich, but Duncan moves out of the way. And Devious is in a bad position here. Moonsault by Duncan. Duncan turning his attention once again to John Rich. Suplex to Rich. And Duncan with a step up and see Corey. Perhaps looking to put this one away right here, Jim Duncan. Slim Blade. Shoulders down, hooks the leg, is it enough to pick up the victory here, final action? Yes it is, Jim Duncan and Shawn Coleman take the victory. Hell of a victory for Shawn Coleman and Jim Duncan as they prepare for their respective championship matches Sunday, October 14th at High Risk. Action rolls on. And we would like to send a special thank you to With Confidence for That's Something. The official theme song for High Risk is available on the band's new album, Love and Loading, which you can stream right now on Spotify and Apple Music. And at High Risk, it's put up or shut up time for both of these women as Emily Welch challenges Michelle Martinez for the WWA Women's Championship. The newcomer in town, Emily Welch, may have been underestimated by the champion. Can the champion, the veteran champion, survive the rookie challenger? We'll find out Sunday, October 14th at High Risk. And for the light heavyweight championship, Kevin Devious goes 1-on-1 against Shawn Coleman. Can Shawn Coleman take the momentum from tonight's tag team victory and turn it into a championship retention Sunday, October 14th? Or will Kevin Devious use the momentum from his previous victory over Coleman to take that championship? We'll find out at High Risk. And the big one, ladies and gentlemen, the national championship on the line in a last man standing match. Jim Duncan goes 1-on-1 against John Rich. John Rich says he wants to end Jim Duncan's career. Jim Duncan says he wants to beat up John Rich and take up his title. Who's gonna win? We'll find out Sunday, October 14th at High Risk. And this was announced last week, or 2 weeks ago, I should say, after the kerfuffle between the new teams in the World Wrestling Association. It will be the Royals, Tim the Kid Mask, Luke Richards, and Jay Westwood against The Watch, Joshua Josh James, Steven Turner, and Johnny McIntyre. Six-man tag team action. Sunday, October 14th, we'll find out who's gonna be the superior team at High Risk. And we are ready for our main event. Guess who's back, everybody? Out of Soul Man making his triumphant return to the World Wrestling Association after winning the Gold Rush tournament a few weeks back. He's got a secure championship main event match at our final pay-per-view of the year, the Showdown at Madison Square Garden, Sunday, December 2nd. Tonight, Pierre goes 1-on-1 against Dante. Yeah. We are back on WWA Action. Dante is set to go 1-on-1 against Adam Cole in our main event. Controlling the waist here. Reversal by Soul. Applies a headlock to Dante. Now a knee to the back of Dante. Soul looking good in the early goings. Oh, I spoke too soon. Dante takes control. Dante now sending Soul to the ropes. They meet in the middle. Soul with the kick. Dropping Dante on his knee. Oh man, look at that shot there by Dante. And Soul is the one reversing now. Soul. Suplex takes down Dante. Shoulders down the ropes while continuing his match. And Dante has been trying to rebuild his image here in the World Wrestling Association. Victory here would do him great favors in that. Nice little drop kick there. Soul now. Planting Dante into the canvas. Damn! For Adam Soul, it's about keeping himself in top shape and form. Remember, he's got that huge main event Sunday, December 2nd. Against whoever the WWA champion is by then. So far, it's still in the mask. Gonna be at Madison Square Garden. Top rope now. Rubbing on Dante, and so far so good for Adam Cole, I'll tell you that. Looking great in that ring, and Dante took a very much well-deserved Adam Cole took a very much well-deserved vacation after winning the World Rush Tournament almost a month ago. Saw here by Soul pushing Dante off him. There's a neck breaker here. A neck breaker dropping down the neck of Adam Soul into the knee. Dante is a dastardly evil when he pushes himself to be. Oh no! Soul gets out of the ring. We have no referee now. Back on his position, Dante off the apron, dropping down a clothesline off the apron on Adam Cole. Dragging the leg here, now hammering on Dante. Dropping him on the knee again. That seems to be working so far so good for Adam Soul. Soul now sending Dante back into the ring. Soul returns. And Soul is looking to finish this one early. Soul doesn't get paid by the hour. He's going for the spear! 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 That should be enough. Adam Soul with the cover. Shoulders down. Is it enough to put Dante away? And it is not! It's not enough! Dante out at two! And now it's back to the drawing board for the winner of the Gold Rush Tournament. He drops down Dante on the top rope. And off the second he goes. Back to square one. for Adam Cole. He gets strategized for this type of resiliency. That's the type of resiliency that Cole is probably going to get from the King Sunday, December 2nd. If he ends up facing the King for the WWA Championship at Madison Square Garden. We're in the middle. Reversal by Adam Cole. Cole now hooks him in, carries him on some of his shoulders. Cole dropping down Dante. That's got to hurt. You can tell that Cole is perhaps a little bit gassed here. And Cole now heads to the top rope. Bad intentions, bad times at the top rope. He drops down, takes out all of the air from Dante. And now Cole is looking to finish this one off once again. Looking to finish it off right here, going for the spear! 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 And that's two if you're counting at home. Shoulders down, hooks the leg. Is it enough to put him away? No, it's not! It's not enough! And now is where the frustration starts to build up. This is when Adam Cole starts to wonder. What the hell do I gotta do? Dropping down the top rope, shoulders down, hook both legs. Is it enough? The kick out of two. This is when Adam Cole goes back to square one for the second time in this match and says, the hell does it take to put away this man? Top rope now. Be careful here off the top rope. Superplex off the top. And not this time, says Dante. Adam Cole looking for a three-peat of that top rope maneuver. Dante says no. Dante looking to finish this one off right here with a shock slam all the way to hell. I think Dante may have taken too much time there to recompose himself. He's taking a lot of punishment in this match. Going for that pile driver. Pile driver! Off the pile driver, shoulders down, but the ropes allow Adam Cole to continue here. Bad measurement there by Dante. As Cole continues in this match. Forearm to the face. Hooks him in. DDT by Cole. And Cole is looking for the third one in this match. If you're counting at home, going for that spear. 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 And that's three if you're counting at home. Shoulders down. Hooks the leg. It's still not enough. How the hell is it not enough? Look, guys, I'm sitting in the announce table and I'm getting frustrated. Can you imagine what's going through the mind of Adam Cole? It's still not enough. Off the top rope again. Shoulders down. Hook both legs. Not enough. Look at those hammering blows by Adam Cole. That's a man who's so over this. When you hit your best move three times in one match and you still can't get the job done, it may be time to rethink it. Ropes again, crossline by Dante, and Dante's all of a sudden back in this match. Oh, man. Reversal here, cross line. To the ropes. They meet in the middle. Reversal by Dante, back and forth we go. Reversal by Cole. These two, very, very hard hitting. A hell of a main event here tonight on WWA Action. Gets sent Dante into the ropes, doesn't hit well with that boot, but he does get Cole on the corner for the spinning DDT. reversal here by Dante. Not giving too much time, going for another tombstone here, but a reversal. Neck breaker by Soul. Into the corner. Set against the corner, but a reversal by Adam Soul. Back and forth we go. Soul now with a punch to the head. You can tell Soul is exhausted. He has given it his all here tonight. And what a battle it's been. Look at this, working the torso of Dante. Very smart move here by Adam Soul. So he can hit that spear for a fourth time in this match. And Adam Soul is measuring Dante here. Going for it here. DDT, signature DDT. And Adam is looking to close this one off. Could it be spear? Spear! Spear! That's four spears if you're counting at home. Shoulders down, hooks a leg. Yes, indeed, Adam Soul gets the victory. A hard foot. What the hell? Mike Carter is here. And Mike Carter dropping Adam Soul after a hard fought battle against Dante. Mike Carter with a gut wrench slam. This is a despicable man here. Double knees to the plexus. Drop kick to the head. Carter with a backache. Message sent to Adam Soul. Thank you for joining us, everybody. Good night.